Good morning friends, welcome to Shekhar Pre Market Roundup, first in the global markets. Yesterday when we closed, most of the European markets were trading down by around 1.5% to 1.75%, whereas the American markets were showing a flattish opening. By the end of the day, with all the news, the European markets recovered a bit and closed down by around 1.25% to 1.5% across the board, whereas the American markets closed on almost flattish note after Dow opening up around 100 points, closed up around 20-25 points. Coming to our markets, after a lot of volatility yesterday, at one point of time Nifty opening in red and then gaining around 50-55 points, finally managed to close up around 50 points. FIIs yesterday was sell around 550 crore rupees in cash market, whereas DI yesterday in cash market were buy around 580 crore rupees, whereas FIIs were buy around 355 crore rupees in index futures. Now let's see our derivatives.
Good morning friends, let's have a view on derivatives. The Indian benchmark indices witnessed a smart recovery in yesterday's trade. However, ignoring the negative cues from the international markets, Nifty started the trade on a flattish to positive note. Though it was trading in a oscillating between positive and negative during most part of the day. But we have seen that Nifty has taken support at around 8,300 levels due to the gains in gains were seen in many of the blue chip counters like IDEA, ZTV, ITC, SBI, which were up in the range of 2% to 4% each. And Nifty finally ended the session at 8,377 levels with a decent gain of 0.70%. In this period, we have seen that long positions were built up by market players as open interest increased by 7.31% from 1 crore 60 lakhs to 1 crore 72 lakhs. Approximately 11.74 lakh shares were added in open interest, and Nifty futures price increased by approximately 60 rupees from 8319 to 8377 odd levels. Nifty cost of carry also increased significantly from 0.11 to 1.35%. Also, Nifty futures increased from 1 point to 9 points. On the options front, PCR has increased marginally by 1% from 1.06 to 1.07, which is clearly indicating that put option has seen good build-up in yesterday's trade. We have seen that put option has added around 25 lakh shares in open interest, whereas call option has added around 21 lakh shares in open interest. India VIX was down by 2% and finally closed at 16.93 odd percentage. In the options activity, we have seen that 8,500 call option has added marginal number of shares in open interest. In the put option side, we have seen that 8,300 put option has added significant number of shares in open interest yesterday's trade, followed by 8,200 put option which has added marginal number of shares in open interest. Looking at the overall option security, we have seen that good buildup was seen in 8,300 put option, which may act as a good support on a closing basis. On ban period front, there is no security in ban period today. On FIIs front, they were net buyers of 800 odd crores in future and options segment. They were net buyers of 353.38 crore in index futures. They were net buyers of 246.40 crore in index options. They were net buyers of 179.61 crore in stock futures. And they were net buyers of 28.94 crore in stock options. A 5-day CDO stands at 8370. Lower range could be 8350 and higher range could be 8500. Currently, Singapore Nifty is down by 23.50 points, which is at 8361. We may see marginal flattish to negative start in Nifty futures today. That's it from everybody. Thank you.
Now, let's have an update on some of the trading ideas and some important news flow for the day. First trading idea in Tata Chemicals. Tata Chemicals is looking to sell its fertilizer business for $1 billion. They have appointed Kotak Mahindra for the to find out the strategic buyer. The overall market cap of Tata Chemical is 10,722 crore rupees, so it's a big chunk. You can see a lot of action happening today in Tata Chemical. Long Tata Chemical with a stop at 413 for a target of 433 and 442. Suhan Life Sciences has been granted another patent issued by Israel, Japan and South Africa for a drug used to treat neurodegenerative diseases. It has a total of 6 granted patents from Israel, 17 from Japan and 20 from South Africa. Action to be taken is long Suhan for stop, with a stop at 229 for a target of 241 and 246. Technology stocks are the next short idea. Global technology spending is set to witness a steep drop this year for 2015. Worldwide IT spending is expected to shrink around 5.5%. In April, Gartner has forecasted a 1.3% fall in technology spend. So So it's a steep jump from 1.3% to 5.5%. Short TCS with a stop at 2603 for a target of 2475 and 2424. And short Tech Mahindra with a stop at 487 for a target of 463 and 454. Greek PM's office has given statement that Greece has asked for another 2 years bailout program from ESM and also has asked for financing and debt restructuring. Finance Telecom major group Orange is looking to buy some of its Bharti Airtel's Africa assets. Core sector growth has risen to 4.4% in May. April-May budget deficit at 2.09 lakh crore rupees. April to May budget deficit has already reached 37.5% of forecast for FY year 15-16. Supreme Court judgment is supposed to come out today in IGL and PNGRB case. PM has launched Digital India week at 4. PM is supposed to launch Digital India week at 4 PM and top 400 CEOs of top 400 companies have been invited. Time Technoplus is looking to sell 50% stake in China JV to Mauser. LIC Housing Finance puts Orbit projects on block. Tata Realty has taken Unitech to High Court over loan default. IndusInd Bank has closed QIP issue. QIP even price at 845 rupees per share. Auto sector volume numbers to be released today. In Maruti, we are expecting positive set of numbers to be released. Hino MotoCorp has introduced another 150cc motorcycle called Extreme Sports with a price at 72,000 rupees in Delhi. Petrol prices has been cut by around 31 paisa and diesel has been cut by around 71 paisa effective midnight. FIPB is supposed to meet on July 3 to consider 13 FDI proposals including Kotak Bank, Hathway Broadband and Dell Networks. Stocks with positive bias are Apollo Tyres, Tata Steel and Ibus Finance. And stocks with negative bias are PFC, Wipro and Sun TV. Stocks for investment are Larsen, Aditya Birla, Tata Motors, Infi and Ultratech. That's all friends from our side. Thanks and bye. Nice reading session.